Some lifecycle models we have seen last time, that is build and fix model we have completed. We have completed the waterfall model also. Okay, so in this lecture, we will try to complete the remaining lifecycle models like rapid prototyping model, incremental model, spiral model, V model, and then we will try to compare the all these models, and also we'll see how to choose one of the required model for your embedded systems. So that is what the agenda for this lecture. Okay. So build and fix model we have seen. In waterfall model also we have seen. Okay. So this is all about the waterfall model. In waterfall model we have seen that we have to design according to the requirements of client or customer. Okay. And also at each and every phase you have to verify those designs, maybe the requirement, maybe the specification, design, implementation. Okay, so all these steps you have to verify in that particular phase itself. Okay, and only after completion of all these steps your product is ready, and then you can supply that product to the customer. So that is only the change in waterfall model, that it comes from up to down. Okay, whereas build and fix model comes that is down to up. That means you first supply the product, and then accordingly we will change the design of your product. So this waterfall model we have seen. We have seen the advantages of waterfall model also. Okay, one of the very good advantages is the documentation driven. Okay, and also in each phase you have the feedbacks. Okay, that means before proceeding to the next phase, you have some feedback loops. Okay, so you will get whatever the positive feedback or negative feedback about your work. And in each phase you have the documentation. So when you design your product next time, you have something in your hand. Okay, that is the documentation. And also it having a lot of advantages we have seen, that is very accurate design you will get by using waterfall model. Okay. Also there are some issues with waterfall model, some disadvantages are there. And also we have seen the examples, means where to use the waterfall model. So I have given this in the retail chain, that is most of the time it is used for inventory management systems, supply chain management systems. Okay. Now we will see the third type of prototyping model, that is called as a rapid prototyping model. Okay, so in the name itself they have explained that this is a prototyping model and it requires the rapid action. Okay, and that means you have to build your product very rapidly. Okay, and you have to put in front of your customer or your client. So in this rapid prototyping model you have to build a rapid prototype. Okay, means in the previous waterfall model the particular model or product is manufactured at the end of all the phases. Okay, however in rapid prototyping model your model or prototype is ready at the first phase itself. Okay, so the client and the future users can interact and experiment with it. Okay, so if your product is ready, so I can give to my client. Okay, and the client and whatever the future users can interact with that particular product, and also they can experiment with that particular product. Okay, now once the client is satisfied with that particular prototype, the developer can draw a specification document. Okay, that means here the procedure is very much reverse way. You have to first supply the product, that is a rapid prototype of your product, to the customer. The customer will work on that. Okay, it will do some experiment on that, and then he will give you the feedback that whether he is satisfied with that particular prototype or not. And only if the client is satisfied, only then the developer will draw up the specification document. That means Once the customer is or client is satisfied, now we will write down all the specification that is needed by the client, because right now client has satisfied with the actual product. So like that product, you have to build different types of product, okay, for that particular client. So to build or to design the particular product, first you have to write down your specification of that particular product in a documented form. So that is what done in the this third step. Now in the fourth step, the feedback loops are not required in this model, as the working prototype has been validated by the client. Okay, so like your waterfall model, here feedback loops are not required. Why these are not required? Because already we are drawing or we are taking all the specifications with the help of client itself. That means the client itself is validating everything. Okay, all the design specification. Okay, at the first phase itself. So that is the reason, like waterfall model, the feedback loops are not required in this rapid prototyping model, since it is validated by the client itself. So that is what the advantage. Next is, it is reasonable to expect that the resulting specification document will be correct. Okay, because now we have the reason, because we have given the product to the customer and we have asked the customer whether you are satisfied with the specification or not. If he is not satisfied, we will do the changes. Okay, if he is satisfied, we will draw the specification from that product and accordingly we will design the number of product for the customer. Okay, so now this is what the rapid prototyping model. Rapid means you have to be very fast, that is creating or fabricating your prototype model, hand over to the client, and accordingly you can make the changes into the your particular product. Now this is what the flow diagram of this rapid prototyping model, okay, which is very much similar to your again the previous waterfall model, or I can say that the fix and build and fix model. Okay, so here if you observe carefully, the first phase is a rapid prototyping. Okay, now if you compare this with a waterfall model, the first phase is the requirement. Okay, and now here the first phase is a rapid prototype. That means I will build a model of that particular product first. Okay, and if the client is satisfied, only then I will draw the specifications from that product. Okay, so in this second phase is called as a specification phase, and this is drawn from the specifications of the prototype. Means once your client is satisfied with the specification, I will use the same specification in the second phase. That is called as a specification phase. Once the specification is finalized or called as a verified, if you observe carefully in those two blocks, rapid prototyping and after that, below that, there is a verify. That means you verify with the client whether he is satisfied with this rapid prototype or not. Similarly, once he is satisfied, you draw the specification, and after drawing the specification, you get check this specification, that is whatever we have drawn, okay, with the help of the prototype. You again re-verify with the help of the client. Otherwise, client say, I have not seen your specification. So that may happen. So to avoid that, you have to verify the specification, that is a drawn specification from the your client itself in the second phase. So this is what the second part called as a verify. So in the first phase also, you have to verify. In the second phase also, you have to verify. Now once specification is finalized, now you have to design. Okay, that means you have to put a layout. Okay, and once you have drawn the layout, before continuing to the next phase, again you have to verify with the help of client. You have to show it to the client. Now whether the client is satisfied with the this design layout or not. If not, you have to work out. If client is satisfied, now you can go to the next phase, that is the fourth phase, That is called as an implementation phase. Now, implementation phase, we have seen what is done in implementation phase. We have to do the software coding and we have to do the hardware implementation. Okay, so that is what done in the implementation. Now, once you have written the program, you have to test. Okay, so below that there is a second part that is called as a test. Test the software code. Similarly, you test the hardware. Okay, so that is what done in the implementation. That is, you write a particular code for each unit, and also you implement the hardware, and you test the individual hardware and individual softwares whether it is working properly or not. Okay. Now, in the next phase, it is an integration phase. Okay, so that is what I have told in last time also. There are different ways of testing. Okay, that is individual testing, unit testing, and the complete system testing. So now you integrate the software and all hardware component as a system, and then you check whether the complete system will work satisfactorily or not. Okay, so if it is work satisfactory, you can deliver to the client. Okay, otherwise you have to find out the bugs and then you have to correct your system. Okay, so that is all about the rapid prototyping. And the last one is a maintenance phase. I have told what is done in maintenance. In maintenance, once the product is delivered to the client will do the changes according to his requirement. So that is what done in the maintenance. And last, retirement phase also we have seen. What is in retirement? Your product will be retired because of the increase in the needs of the client. Okay, and your product is not able to satisfy those requirements. This is the reason why we retire the product from the market. And if you show the all dotted lines, that has come back as a feedback, and you have to change the requirement. Okay, so in the maintenance phase, if a client want to change some adjust or do some adjustment or changes, he is able to do it by using this maintenance. Okay, so this is all about rapid prototyping model. Only the change, just see, all the phases remain same. That is from requirement, specification, design phase, implementation phase, integration phase, maintenance phase, and the retirement phase. So all phases will be the same. Okay, but there is some changes in the first stage or the last stage. So in the rapid prototyping model, rather than continuing with the requirement, here we will supply one kind of product to the client. Okay, and client will do the experiment with that product, and if he satisfied with that product, we will draw the specification from that product. Okay, and then we will continue to integrate our next phases. Okay, so this is only the change. Whereas in waterfall model, you are not getting the product at the first phase. Okay, this is the difference. In waterfall model, the product is ready at the last phase. Whereas in rapid prototyping model, the product is ready in the first stage itself. Okay, so this is also one of the good thing. Okay, for example, you are designing some mobile and you are getting your mobile after 1 year, and you have the another company which will supply you the sample or prototype mobile in the first stage itself. Okay, so which is the or which kind of mobile you prefer? Maybe you prefer the second type because you are getting the hands-on on your mobile at the first day itself. Okay, so if you are comfortable with that kind of mobile, you can continue with that mobile, or you can suggest some changes to the mobile also. So that is what the advantage with a rapid prototyping model. So what is done in this rapid prototyping model that I have explained? So I will try to explain all these points again. So in rapid prototyping, we have to construct the prototype as rapidly as possible. Then the developer should develop the rapid prototype as rapidly as possible for the speed up of the software development process. Okay, means try to develop your product rapidly. Okay, so once you develop your product rapidly, you can speed up the development of your software process. Okay, so that is what the advantage. Next is use of rapid prototype determine what the client's real needs are. Yes, this is very important point. Means if you use a rapid prototyping model, so the actual needs of your clients can be implemented in the first page itself. Otherwise, what happens? Likewise, we are purchasing the house, okay? And after purchasing a house, you are doing the modification in the house, in that house, okay? So why not to get the house in the first phase itself according to your modifications, okay? So this is what the rapid prototyping model, or the advantage of rapid prototyping model. Now, rapid prototype implementation is discarded because of some disadvantages we'll see. And also prototype is modified rapidly to reflect client needs. Okay, that means it is possible to modify your prototype also to implement your client needs. Now, what are the advantages there of this rapid prototyping model? Okay. So first advantage is users or customers' own requirement can be implemented in the first phase itself. Otherwise, what happens? We are doing all the theoretical process, and after that, you are getting the product in your hand. And after getting your product, you will know that some of the features that are not good and that are not comfortable to you. So you want to change. So again, if you go for the changes, now again, you require a lot of time. So this process is something lengthy or tedious. So rather than this, if your needs are implemented in the first phase itself, so that is well and good. So that's why rapid prototyping model is also one of the good choice for the users. Next is advantage, installs customer confidence that the right product is being built. Okay, this is very important. In the first day itself, if you are getting the mobile of your whatever the dream, okay, then you are happy with that particular product. And once you are happy with that product, you can do the marketing of such a kind of product. I will give a simple example of Royal Enfield, okay, Bullet. Okay, so actually, do you know the parent company of Royal Enfield? Anybody? Which is the parent company of Royal Enfield? Who is that is owner of the Royal Enfield? Anybody? Who owns the Royal Enfield? Bullet. Anybody? Everybody is using this Bullet. You have heard the name Eicher Trucks Stamports. Okay, so just say Eicher owns this Royal Enfield. Okay, so Royal Enfield is not a different company. This is owned by Eicher. So that is one of the product of Eicher. One that is Royal Enfield Bullet. Another is trucks, and it having the partners from foreigns also. Okay, so that is one of the Indian company. Okay, now why I have used that as an example over here? Because you have to install the confidence into customer. Okay, so if you observe the very good example of this Royal Enfield. They are not doing marketing. If you observe, have you seen the advertise of Royal Enfield? You have not seen much kind of marketing from, not a digital marketing, okay, not any print, that is called as a print marketing also. Why this is so? Because the marketing of this Royal Enfield is not done by the that is we called as a, we are using a digital advertisement for. We are using some models from Kate or from Hollywood, Bollywood, likewise. But they are not using these kinds of marketing tricks because they don't need this type of marketing. They have very good product in the market itself. And the marketing of these kinds of company is done by the customer itself. Okay. So if I purchase the Royal Enfield, I'm happy with that product. Okay. So I will do the marketing of that. Oh, you can purchase the Royal Enfield, it gives very good performance. Are you getting? So no need of marketing. So why this is so? Because now I have the confidence into that particular product. And once I have the confidence, I can do the marketing on myself. They are not telling you to do the marketing, but still we are doing the marketing. Just see. So this is what the impact of confidence if you get the product in hand at the first half or first phase itself. Now next advantage is It provides a good way to determine requirements when there is uncertainty about what is needed. Provides a good way to determine requirement when there is uncertainty about what is needed. Okay, the same. So this statement is nothing but the same as compared to the first statement. That is, it will install the customer's requirements. Okay, that is, rather than putting some kind of random product in front of your clients, we will put the product in front of your client. Okay, according to the needs of the clients. As compared to waterfall model, now this is what compared rapid prototype model is compared to waterfall model. So in this, feedback loops are less likely to be needed. Okay, that means in rapid prototyping model, you don't require the feedback loops. So this will save you a lot of time. Okay. So all these are the advantages of rapid prototyping model. Now, if your system having some advantages, it definitely have some disadvantages. So what are the different disadvantages of rapid prototyping model that we'll see one by one. So the first disadvantage is that it requires lot of customer involvement, which is not always possible. Okay. If user not involved in lifecycle, model is not useful. Okay. That means, let's say, I am the customer. And I want some product from some company. So the procedure is, some of the people from company will come to me and I will discuss what kind of product I will require. Now this is what the normal procedure to fabricate or design any kind of product. Now the problem is, every time if they come to me for the verification, so I am not going to give that much of time. Because I have my own work. So I am not going to give that much of time, okay, or intention to those people. That is, I am not 100% involved into that particular process. So that is what one of the problem. That is, it requires a lot of customer involvement. That means you have a lot of time on your side also. Okay, company will give the 100% time, but the client also has to give some time. So this is not possible every time. And if this is not possible, your product will not be a good. Okay, that means what kind of product you will expect. So that kind of product you will not get at the end. So that is what the problem. So very important constraint in this type of modeling is that is, customer must be involved in the process. Otherwise, you are not getting a good quality product. Second disadvantage, development time may not be reduced if reusable components are not available. Okay, as this is what the case. Okay, so if the required reusable components are not available, so you require a lot of time. Next, third disadvantage, prototypes are not always thrown away. Rather than, they often become the products or fundamental parts of the product. That means the first prototype you have supplied to the customer, he has done all the experiment, and after the experimentation, he is not going to throw away, or even company is not going to throw away that prototype. So either that prototype is modified, or the parts of that prototypes are disintegrated, and you will use the same kind of same parts for the next product. Okay, so that may happen. That is also one of the disadvantages. Fourth disadvantage is, highly specialized and skilled developers are expected, and such developers may not be available easily. Okay, so there are very few people which are highly specialized and highly skilled. Okay, and because you are throwing the product in front of your client in the first phase, so this is very difficult thing. Okay, the normal procedure is that you have to design your product according to the requirement of client, and at the last phase you have to deliver the product. But in this case, the product is delivered in the first phase itself. Okay, so to deliver such a kind of product, the designers or developers should be highly specialized and skilled into that area. And the people of this caliber is not seen regularly. Okay, so that is a lack of these kinds of people. Last disadvantage is that client expects changes to be made as rapidly as the rapid prototype. Okay, so now everyone is very busy and want all the things in a very short time. Okay, so this is what the disadvantage also, because your product cannot be made available with the changes rapidly. It requires certain time. So that is also one of the disadvantage. So this is all about rapid prototyping model. Are you comfortable, everybody? Are you getting the things or not? Let me know yes or no. The chat box, I'm not getting the chat box. Are you getting the things or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will go to the next. I will go to the next prototyping model. So just see, it's very simple. Actually, it's in all the models are in very much in detail. Okay, but you can at least you get the idea. Okay, that is what is rapid prototype model. What is waterfall model? And what is build and fix model? You have to just remember the idea, what is done in this particular model. Okay, rest of the things are very simple. Again, you have to draw similar kind of that flow. Now next model is called as an incremental model. Also, we have seen this incremental model in the previous example itself. Now what is done in incremental model that I have told last time, that is, in incremental model, I will purchase a house, okay. And now, in each iteration, I will change my whatever the house according to my design, okay. Whatever I my needs, I will change the design of my house, okay. And there is another type of model we have seen, that is iterative model. Now, what is done in iterative model? I will purchase a house. But if this is not according to my requirement, I will redesign and again I will build another house. Okay. Now this is not the feasible option. But in incremental type of model, what you can do, you can purchase a product and you can improve that product. You can increase the features of that particular product. For example, I will purchase a that is a Nokia phone. Okay. But that is not sufficient to me. So I will increase the different features into that particular mobile. So that is called as an incremental model. And what is build and fix model? I will purchase one mobile, but that is not according to my specifications. So I will purchase the another mobile which having the my particular features. Okay, and maybe after a few years, I will require more features. So that time again, I will go to the next mobile. Means I will purchase the next mobile, third mobile. So this is not a good thing. Rather than in the same mobile, if you get all the features, or if you are able to upgrade all the features, that is a very good thing. So that is nothing but the incremental model. Okay. So you can observe the incremental model. That is requirement phase. Again, requirement phase, verify. Specification phase, verify. Architectural design, verify. Okay. And very importantly, that is for each build, you have to perform detailed design, implementation, and integration. You have to test, and only then you have to deliver to the client. Okay. There are a number of build phases. Okay. Means maybe the iteration. That is, I will purchase a house. Okay. This is the first build. Now in the second build, I will modify my house. Okay, for example, I will modify some of the kitchen types of things. Okay, in the second build, in the third, I will do some furnitures. Okay, in the fourth, I will do some other